out Wembley concerts. Today, Martin Frizzell takes a look at how McCartney gets the green message over to both his crew and the audience.
When you're on the road with vegetarian Paul McCartney, you do as the boss does. You don't eat meat backstage. There's only one Big Mac allowed on this tour, McCartney himself.
People make a big fuss about this. It's really not that much of a fuss. Really, all that happened is that on a tour like this through my company, MPL, I end up paying for the food that the 85 people eat. So I couldn't buy meat. I wouldn't do it. It's against my principles. So Linda had a hard job, you know, just had to really make some great menus that would satisfy these sort of big, tough truckers and riggers.
I've been cooking this way for 20 years, so I know how healthy it is and how it's not cranky. If you take your meat recipes and instead of putting the dead flesh in there, you put a textured vegetable protein, which tastes just like meat, but nothing was murdered or suffered for that reason. Plus, it's unhealthy. So we thought, well, let's get some great caterers. So, and keep it really healthy and for everyone and see how it goes. And I mean, I've had so many of the crew and everything come up to me and say, this food is great. I'll have to go vegetarian when I get home. I don't know how I'm going to get my wife to cook it, you know, but it's going great. But it was really because we love animals.
Are you a vegetarian, Curtis?
No, I'm not.
So how do you get on with the food on this tour?
Oh, I manage. I try a few dishes here and there. We have a few nice dishes.
If you were caught in here with a Big Mac, what would happen to you?
You get the big boot?
Yeah. Get the big boot for the Big Mac, and also the caliber of this tour, we're really respectful as far as, what are you doing? No, that's Keith over there. Come here, Keith. He's eating a Big Mac right now. What are you eating?
When you were young and your heart was an open book, you used to say, live and let live. This ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry. Say, live and let die.
Not only do the McCartneys want to save animals, they've joined the growing lobby to save the world. Friends of the Earth leaflets are given out at concerts, and McCartney stops his show to make the point.
When you get a chance to vote, just tell your politicians you want to live in a clean world. It's the only way they'll do it, if you tell them. And if they don't, chuck them out.
So really all I do is I say, look, you know, there's these people called the Friends of the Earth. They think we ought to stop polluting rain, sky, sea, land, everything. And, you know, we are the only species on Earth that soils its own nest. Everybody else, all of the little birds and stuff, they always go over there to take a dump. But we don't. You know, right here. There ain't no problem at all. You know, Britain, like, we accept the world's nuclear waste. I mean, what about that? We just said, don't worry, we'll bury it in big cans under the sea. Gonna be fine down there. Everyone goes, ah, you know, no. And I mean, after all, they're only our elected representatives. It's not God there, you know. I know Maggie sometimes looks like her, but it isn't God, it's only the people we voted in.
good one. I've just got visions of all those big roadies running out for hamburgers. But good for Paul McCartney sticking to his principles. And tomorrow, in our final look behind the scenes, the making of the movie of the